हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज द कमिंग ऑफ सोशलिज्म इन यूरोप एंड इन द लास्ट वीडियो व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इंडस्ट्रियल एंड सोशल चेंज व्हाट वाज देयर इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन केम इन यूरोप देन दैट इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन केम विद मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स for the working class. That industrialization came with the many problems for the working class. And today we'll discuss about the coming of socialism in Europe. Right. So the idea of socialism. In the very first video of this chapter, I told you about the socialism. Socialism means two type of ideology. One is capitalism, one is socialism. Capitalism means to earn whosoever is having the resources, earn that, use that resources and make yourself rich. Right. What is there in socialism? Socialism means we have to take all the people together. Every people will work together and they will divide the profits together. Right. This is socialism. Means everyone will work together and earn together. Nobody will lag behind. Everyone will be equal in the society. Right. So, by the mid-19th century, the idea of socialism attracted wide attention. Because, I told you in the last video, with the industrialization, many problems with the working class. What kind of problem? Housing problem, long working hours, less wages, sanitation. These problems were there. Inequality were there. Right. But now what the socialism was saying? Socialism was saying that everybody will be equal. So, this attracted the widespread people. This idea of socialism attracted widespread attention and those who followed this idea were known as a socialist. Means the idea of socialism that was the all people will work together and will be equal, that idea attracted a lot of people towards socialism. And those who were following the ideology of socialism, they were known as a socialist. Right. And next thing, socialists were against the private property. Why they were against the private property? Reason was there. Because private property, whosoever is having the property, they are setting up their industry. After that, they are earning the profit. And of that profit, they are using for themselves. They are not taking care of the workers. Right. That's why they were against the private property, that no private property is to be there. They considered private property as the root cause of problems in the society, because they were thinking that this is the private property is the root cause, main cause of the problem in the society. Reason is that because those who were having the property, they were earning a lot of money, they were setting up the industries and they were hiring the workers. And they were not paying the attention towards the welfare of the workers. Right, they were producing the thing or earning for the private property owners. And the profit gained by the private property owners, they were using for themselves, not for the property, so not for the workers. Right. So next thing, individuals own property, that is private property, and workers under them, workers working under them. What was their individuals were owning, they were on the property, they own the property and workers have to work under them. So they were not paying individuals. Means the person, those who were having the factory, they were not paying any attention towards the workers. Right. And they were paying. Individuals were only concerned about the personal gains. They were only concerned about the personal gains, not with the welfare of workers. They were not concerned about the welfare of the workers, but they were only concerned about the personal gain. They were not thinking that they want more and more profits of what they were doing. They were taking the work from the workers for very long hours, as well as they were giving them very less wages. Right. So next thing, what is there? Socialists wanted a society as a whole control property. Means society will control the property as a whole. No private property is needed. No private property is needed. This was the idea of socialism. This was the idea of socialism. And socialism won't change. Socialism, socialist wanted changes. And who gave this idea? Who gave this idea? The idea was given by many philosophers. The ideas were given by many philosophers, and these were some of the philosophers: Robert Owen, Louis Blanc, Karl Marx, as well as Friedrich Engels. These were the main philosophers or the person, those who gave the idea regarding the socialism, regarding the idea of socialism. First we'll discuss about the idea of Robert Owen and the Louis Blanc. What is their socialists? Socialists, there were different kind of socialism, means different visions of socialism and different branches of capitalism. Some socialists had different visions of future, right? Some believe that idea of cooperative. Some believed the idea of cooperative. What is cooperative? Cooperative means association of people. Means people's association, people will work together. And working together, earn profit and divide equal. Whatever the profits they are earning, they divide the profit accordingly. They divide the profit accordingly. Right. So, what is the idea of the Robert Owen? He was saying, so to be, build a cooperative community. Means there is need to build a cooperative community, new harmony of Indiana, USA. What he said? He said the idea of cooperative. The idea of a cooperative means every person will work. He was born in England. What was there? He was born in England. He set up the cooperative in USA, right? With the name of New Harmony of Indiana. It means everyone will work together. Means he was saying जिसको जो काम मिला है वो अपना अपना काम करे. Means they through the collective individual initiative. Collective individual initiative means जिसका जो काम है उसको वो काम करे तो क्या होगा? That is known as socialism. That is the idea of cooperative. Then what will be there? What the whole work will complete and they divide the profit. And they divide the profit. This was the idea of the Robert Owen. And next idea of Louis Blanc. Louis Blanc was also saying the cooperative, but under the control of government. But under the control of government. So government, he supported cooperatives encouraged. Sorry, government encouraged cooperatives to replace capitalist enterprise. That cooperatives will replace the capitalist. Means all person work together, right, and replace the capitalist. Capitalist means individual, those who were earning profit. And government should be there to facilitate cooperatives. And government is needed to provide some facilities to the cooperative that will run the cooperatives. Right, these were the ideas of Robert Owen and Louis Blanc. And next we'll discuss about the idea of Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. After the Louis Blanc, who was there? Karl Marx and the Friedrich Engels. Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels. What they said? they edit their ideas with their ideas. They edit their ideas with the ideas of these thinkers, right? What they said, but the Karl Marx, most important person of this chapter, Karl Marx. Marx argued the capitalist invested in the factories and profit of them is earned by workers. What the Marx was saying that the money that is invested by the capitalist, no issue. But the factory, in the factory, the profit that is earned by the workers, that is earned by the workers, right? The condition of the workers is not so good. The condition of the workers is not so good. How the workers can improve their condition? They can improve their condition. The condition of workers will not improve till the time when this profit is accumulated by the private property. Means whatever the profit is earned by the workers, that profit till the time is accumulated by the private property or the capitalist or the private property owner, till that time workers condition will not improve. Workers have to fight against the capitalism, right? So workers have to overthrow capitalism and free themselves from their exploitation. If workers want to improve their condition, then what is needed? There is need of overthrow of capitalism and free themselves from the clutches of the exploitation of a private property. Right. Next, workers had to construct a radically society. Radically means a society that would complete change and aggressive instant change. Workers had to construct a radical society where all property is controlled by society, where all property is controlled by society, and that are known as communist. What he want? He wanted that workers will conduct a society, radical society, that will control all the property of the society, and that is known as a communist society. So, what is said by the Karl Marx, a communist society was the natural society of a future. He said that communist society is the natural society of a future. So, this was our topic, the coming of socialism in Europe. In the next video, we'll discuss or we'll start with the topic, the Russian Revolution. Till that time, revise and make the notes very carefully. Stay home, be safe, and be healthy. Thank you.